burned.
For Christ's sake, I've been waiting for you all night. Where have you been?
Oh, just prowling around, really.
Just prowling around. That's suitably vague. You look like something the cat dragged in.
I wish I had.
What was that?
Nothing. I didn't say a thing, Ma.
You most certainly did. Now get out of those grubby clothes.
I'm fine, Ma. I can manage. I'll change upstairs.
I really want to know what you just mumbled at me. A little clear communication with your old Ma. I'm all ears, dear. What is going on with you? You're out to all hours? You're more secretive than ever? You're sullen. All the features a parent loves to see in her precious spawn.
Truly, Mom, there's nothing going on in my life right now.
Come on, darling. Throw me a bone, a tidbit, a morsel. How about a little news of the day or a bit of conversation?
Okay. Well, you know that sock that went missing a while back?
Yeah.
The striped one. I found it. It was under the bed, predictably. Okay, we done, Ma. Good night.
I don't mean to pry, dear. But if there's something wrong, maybe I can help.
There's no help for it.
What is it? A new girlfriend?
No girlfriend, Ma.
A boyfriend?
No, Ma. No boyfriend. Look, can we just drop this for now? I want to go upstairs and get changed. And
Junior! Junior! What are you hiding from me? A mother knows when there's something going on with her child, and there's most certainly something going on with you. Now, please, hold forth.
Okay. If you really want to know, you're not gonna like it.
Oh, baby. How bad could it be?
For a long time now, I haven't been feeling right, and
oh,
I don't...
Oh, no! Are you sick?
No, Ma. Well, some people might say so.
Some people? What people?
You know, I've never really fit in. I've always been marginal. Now it's absolutely clear to me that I need a change. I can't go on trapped in this body anymore.
Oh no! You want a sex change! I'm gonna have to start buying brassieres for my 34-year-old son!
What? God, no, Ma.
No? So what then? And where the hell have you been all night?
It was just a gathering of people who...
A gathering of people who what?
People who like to dress up and...
Here we go with the dress up.
People who like to dress up like animals. They call themselves furries.
Oh, Junior, what a relief.
Thank you so much for your support.
But what do you mean? You don't want to be trapped in your body anymore?
That's just it, Ma. I don't want to just dress up anymore. I want to make it permanent.
Make what permanent?
The change, Ma. I want A complete species makeover.
A what? My God. I'm trying to imagine what that would entail. Has it ever even been done? You're not gonna be a guinea pig, are you?
No, a cat.
But what about your friends? Your community? The fuzzies?
It's furries, Mom.
The furries. Being with them doesn't satisfy this impulse?
It's not just an impulse, Mom. I've really only ever been a fringe furry anyway.
They're mostly a bunch of bozos.
I want the real thing. The tail. The enhanced senses. The innocence. Not this bullshit facsimile in a plush outfit. In this absurd, counterintuitive costume. Down on all fours is a place of balance and power. Closer to the sweet earth. I want to take a real walk on the wild side.
But, Junior, you weren't raised in the wild. You have no practical skills. How will you survive out there? What about comforts and conveniences? Are you willing to give up regular meals, hot baths? A warm, soft, cozy bed? Drugs and alcohol?
Ah, hell with that, Ma. What is all of that compared to freedom and complete autonomy? What is all of that compared to maintaining a healthy population of non-humans? I want to remember how to truly appreciate warmth and food. I want to remember. And I want to forget.
But, Junior, how are you going to pay for all this? It must cost a fortune. And what kind of ghoul even does this sort of thing?
I know a guy who knows a guy. Doesn't cost as much as you might think.
Well, hell bells. You pretty much always have done what you pleased. So I don't suppose the expense or difficulty or just plain goddamn weirdness of it will stop you.
Well, you're right about that. I gotta do it soon. Rex and I, we agreed to be ready for St. Francis of Assisi's feast day. The blessings of the beast, Ma.
Oh, Rex? That nice fellow from your fitness club? Didn't you say he has a girlfriend?
Yeah, but he's in. We made a pact. Pause for the cause.
Thank you. down.
My, it's been such a long time. Seems like months. You haven't changed a bit.
Yeah, it has been a few months. How have you been doing?
All things considered, I can't complain. I managed to keep myself busy. How about yourself? How's that lady friend of yours?
Well, I'm doing good. Real good. And my lady friend, Marianne, she is wonderful. We actually found a little place across town, and we're actually starting on settling down. And I got a full-time job at the fitness club. Things there have been really starting to work out. As a matter of fact,
my goodness. Congratulations, you'll do just fine.
Oh,
Junior, Rex is here. Junior!
Rex! Rex!
Oh, there you are, you old dog. How are you?
I'll let you two catch up.
Well, well.
You haven't changed a bit. Long time no see, pal. How are you?
Junior. Yeah. Long time. I'm doing good, man. Doing good. But, dude, look at you. And look at that fine outfit you're wearing. That must have set you back a brick or two.
Outfit? What outfit?
This fucking awesome set of threads you got here.
Ow! Hey, motherfucker! This is no outfit! It's the genuine article! The real deal! The cat's ass!
What? You've gotta be shitting me! What the
Rex,
hell?
Rex, you and I, we agreed!
You maniac! You actually did it!
Yes, I did it! As per our agreement! Clearly, you did not.
You didn't actually expect me to go through with it, did you? It's just plain nuts.
What about our pact? The courage of your convictions? And what about the deadline?
What deadline?
St. Francis' feast day. The blessings of the beast, Rex.
Oh, Jesus. Junior, I have a life. I can't just walk away from it.
You chickened out.
Wait. Weren't you going to be living in the state park or something? But you're still here, in your mom's house, wearing clothes no less.
It's that girlfriend of yours, isn't it? I bet you got her pregnant. And I bet it was an accident. Talk about nuts. Traitor.
Yeah? What about it? She did think it was cool at first. But then, you know, she got all creeped out. She said, "We have babies. They'll be monsters, you know. So what's your excuse?"
It's complicated.
No, really isn't everything.
Look, my ma's always been good to me. Better than I deserve, really. She's getting older and I owe it to her to see her through. I had to stay.
All right. But what about this?
I work a few days at the interpretive center at the park.
Brings in a few bucks. Now that is even more nuts.
Yeah? Well, isn't everything?
Well, Junior, good luck with that. I should get going. I gotta go home and do a shift with my junior.
Your junior. Yeah, pal. Good luck with that.
Did your friend already leave?
Friend? Yeah. He's gone.
Oh. Well, dearie, don't let that putz bother you. Look. I've got some lovely bristling sardines. Your favorite. And the late show is about to come on. Come sit next to your old mom.